The show Smashdown opens with Team Retro in the arena. Rob, Mr. Game & Watch, Pac-Man, and Duck Hunt. Rob, Mr. Game & Watch, who in the previous week won the Smashdown Team Battle Championships, begin their little speech. In essence, they say that they plan on all four of them holding all four of the Smashdown title belts as soon as possible. Pac-Man is aiming for the Smashdown Championship, while Duck Hunt is aiming for the Brawlers Championship. At the end of their long, maniacal, evil villain spiel, Bowser arrives on the scene in an attempt to fight them off, 4 versus 1, yet again. Well, Bowser is out here to try and take on Team Retro all by himself.
That's not even remotely right what they're trying to do. Hold every position. That'll give them complete control.
Rob and Mr. Game & Watch are already Team Battle Champions. And it's a force of four. No one person has the ability to take them out. But Bowser is doing his best. All 111%. And he's just thrown out. Rob?
The only one that even took damage was,
Duck Hunt. He had 44.
Overpowered much?
Very much.
With Bowser out of the way, Rob, Game & Watch, Pac-Man, and Duck Hunt felt they can continue on with their little spiel. Unfortunately for them, Dark Pit decides to jump into the ring as well.
Just Dark Pit?
Just Dark Pit.
Dark Pit is our Brawlers champion. He won that last week.
Oh my goodness.
Trying to...
Still total chaos.
Duck Hunt is still hurt from... Oh my gosh.
Well, at least only Duck Hunt didn't take damage this time.
Robin Game & Watch took a little bit of damage, but...
Not enough to mean anything.
Team Retro just demolishing.
As soon as Dark Pit went down, Charizard and Lucario arrived on the scene in an attempt to make war with Rob and Game & Watch, the current Team Battle Champions.
At least it's a little bit more likely with a team against those four, but still.
It's still 2-on-4.
They're still dealing quite a bit of damage.
Lucario has to take full advantage of Double Team right now. It's just too much. They're taking too much damage too fast. Charizard tried to go for Flare Blitz on Mr. Game & Watch, but Rob just hit him with a Robo Beam. It's a 3-on-1 situation on Charizard on one side, and Charizard quickly goes down and could not handle the numbers.
Maybe that aura will come in handy for Lucario.
Oh, the down smash.
It's over, but everyone was hurt that time.
With all of their enemies thoroughly demolished, Team Retro leaves and heads backstage to take a breather. They feel like they have total control already. The following contest is a two-stock match. Introducing first, King DD, and his opponent representing Team Retro, Pac-Man.
Three, two, one, go!
Pac-Man says he's looking for the Smashdown Championship. Bowser won that, facing King DDD. Beating King DDD here one-on-one will be a good way for Pac-Man to get into that spotlight. King DDD still looks to like he has control. That Gordo would have done so much damage. Oh, grabbed by Pac-Man. Down throw. And a dash. Missed the side smash. Missed the side smash twice. A back throw by King DDD. Blocked the side smash. Standard combo missed by King DDD. Several blocked attacks and an up throw by Pac-Man. He got the key, and it connected with King DDD. Wasting little time in throwing the key, hitting both the Gordo and King DDD. Back and run. The forward throw does not kill Pac-Man. Missed the side smash. Back throw. Not enough. Missed the up aerial.
Whoa.
Forward aerial.
Still not
Still
enough.
Still not enough. Missed the up aerial again. Oh, but Gordo sent back. Unlike Bowser's fire, Pac-Man's projectiles are strong enough to reflect the Gordo attack. And the back throw? Not quite enough. Pac-Man sees the Smash Ball. He immediately goes for it. King DDD manages to get it. And there it is. The DDD burst. Connects. And it does kill Pac-Man. Pac-Man doesn't have a whole lot of room to make up, he just needs to make it up quickly. Or it'll become too much.
Whoa.
Nice move by Pac-Man using the Pac Dot chain to get through DDD. Dodging his own fire hydrant. Nice move. And the side smash takes him out. 47% is not too much ground to make up. It's not impossible, but it's still a slight disadvantage. Again, dodging his fire hydrant.
Another grab.
Kicking the Gordo right back. Missed the orange. Missed the fire hydrant. Missed the Gordo.
Back up almost even in percentages.
Oh, the up aerial does a lot of damage, but not quite enough. Forward throw.
Oh, that
Ooh,
hammer would have ended
nice.
It.
Oh, King D caught the King D caught the orange. There is the fire hydrant right onto the head. Missed the jet cannon. The orange hits Pac-Man right in the face. Cherry's miss, up smash.
Not quite enough.
The up smash again. That does it. Pac-Man defeats King DDD, putting himself in the spotlight for a Smashdown Championship match. The following contest is a three-stock match. Introducing first, representing Team Retro, Duck Hunt, and his opponent, Jigglypuff. Duck Hunt says that he's looking for a shot at the Brawlers Championship, currently held by Dark Pit. we saw Dark Pit, the Mega Powers, and Bowser all get demolished at the start of the show by Team Retro. It's really interesting to see how that all turns out. Jigglypuff needs to get some good hits in. She does not have the greatest recovery in the world, but she can definitely hit hard when she wants. But all of Duck Hunt's projectiles is just keeping her away. Only got the first hit on the up smash, not enough to do anything. Roll out, does not connect. Came close though, back aerial. Ooh.
Jigglypuff is gone at the first stop.
Back aerial by Duck Hunt takes out Jigglypuff. Nice back throw by Jigglypuff. Jigglypuff's throws are not really anything too special. Nice, pound connects. At least gets Duck Hunt away from her.
Smash ball. Jigglypuff's got it.
Jigglypuff's got it. She uses it at the far end of the stage. All Duck Hunt has to do is stay away. Puff Up does not connect. Wow. The down smash takes Jigglypuff out of rollout. Oh! That is such a weird angle her down smash hits you at. Missing with the forward aerial, side smash takes out Duck Hunt. 45%, not too bad to come back from. And there's still two stocks in the match. Getting two forward aerials in, dodging a side smash, but a back throw from Duck Hunt does catch Jigglypuff. Roll out, missed. The Wild Gunman connects with Jigglypuff. Forward aerial. Nice up smash. Missing the rollout, and the side smash takes her out.
That's stuck for Jigglypuff.
She came back too quickly and got caught. She needs to take out Duck Hunt quickly. Oh! Not quite enough. There's a back throw. She gets it, and that is very close to Duck Hunt. He might not have any choice but to get launched. And there he goes. Duck Hunt is down, only 20% by Jigglypuff taken. Yep, Smash connects, not enough to take out Jigglypuff. Missed the Yep Smash there, but got a forward throw. And there's the Yep Smash for the kill.
Team Retro is just killing everybody.
With both non-championship members of Team Retro earning victories in the beginning of the night, it is not too hard to say that what Team Retro wants may very easily come true. Ladies and gentlemen, before we continue on, I can confirm that tonight's main event will be Dark Pit and Bowser versus Rob and Game & Watch of Team Retro. So that is something to definitely look forward to. But here we have Lucario and Charizard, the Mega Powers, versus the Princesses, Rosalina and Luma, and Peach. This is a two-stock match. I almost didn't change that. After the beating Lucario and Charizard took earlier in the night, it's amazing that they're even ready to compete in this match. Nice double team there by Lucario, hitting Rosalina. The Luma is going to be tough to deal with, especially in a team battle. It's like a third member of the team. So what they need to focus on is they need to get Rosalina and Luma out quickly. There goes the Luma, and that's become more of a two-on-two situation, excuse me. Nice down smash by Rosalina, connecting with both of their opponents. There goes Charizard to a side smash.
And now Luma is back.
And Luma is back, bright and blue. Nice down throw by Charizard, breathing some fire on the face of Peach. There goes Rosalina, not quite enough. There goes Rosalina to a, and here comes Mega Lucario. Mega Lucario needs to be careful not to attack his own partner here. And it looks like he's going to try and focus on Rosalina, get some more damage off while he can. There goes Peach. Another Luma on the field. Rosalina and Peach currently at a disadvantage, two stocks to three. Lucario trying to take out the Luma with a fully charged Aura Sphere, not quite enough. A side smash from Rosalina. Luma in the air takes out Charizard, and he is gone, but his share stock and he comes back. However, that leaves Lucario with one stock and 92%.
Take out Lucario as soon as possible.
Yeah, especially with Aura and Rage, he can do too much damage all at one time with both Aura and Rage.
There went Luma.
Luma is gone. Rosalina was almost taken out right there. A side smash by Lucario, not quite enough to take out Peach.
Another Luma back in the field.
Luma is back. Oh! The Aura Sphere and the Side Smash from Lucario and Rosalina respectively took each other out. And it's down like to Charizard and Rosalina. And there's
Peach.
The Smash. Right, Peach. Sorry. The Smash Ball is on the field. And it looks like Charizard gets it. Here comes Mega Charizard X. Both members of the Mega Powers able to use their Mega Evolutions in this match. The Fire Blast connects, and that's a one shot. Ladies and gentlemen, the Mega Powers proving that they are still a force to be reckoned with in the tag team division. Backstage the arena, Lucina challenges Ike to a rematch next week, a 300 HP battle. At first, Ike refuses, but after a bit of persuasion by Lucina, saying that Ike is possibly too scared to fight a girl more than once, Ike accepts the challenge. Next week, Lucina versus Ike, 300 HP. The following contest is a 3-minute timed match. Introducing first, Mewtwo, and his opponent, Zero Suit Samus. First shots made by Zero Suit Samus. Wow! Down smash, side smash combo, that is really powerful. Times Mewtwo has landed a disable and a smash combo. That time it almost cost Zero Suit Samus a life there. That would have given Mewtwo the advantage. Ooh, first thought goes to Mewtwo. It is 1-1 right now. Reflecting the Paralyzer Blast. Didn't do much damage, but Mewtwo was unable to take advantage. And Mewtwo grabs the Smash Ball. Here comes Mega Mewtwo Y with Psy Strike, and it connects. Mewtwo is really giving Zero Suit Samus a tough job here. There's 1 minute left in 1 minute left in the match. Zero Suit Samus needs to never mind. It is now 2-2. 1-1. Zero Suit Samus needs to get a quick kill. And she needs to do it within the next 42 seconds. However, Zero Suit Samus is not known for her power. Dominant performance, getting a 2-kill lead at one point in the game. Not for very long, but long enough for it to matter. Mewtwo gets a victory over Zero Suit Samus. Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is a 3-stock team battle match. Introducing first, the Brawler's champion, Dark Pit. And his partner, the Smashdown champion, Bowser. And their opponents, representing Team Retro, the Smashdown Team Battle Champions, Mr. Game & Watch and Rob. Three, two, one, go! With both the other members of Team Retro earning victories in their match here tonight, it'd be safe to say that Mr. Game Watch and Rob here plan to not be outdone. Especially going up against two singles competitors. Dark Pit and Bowser do not have much team synergy, but Game & Watch and Rob have been apparently known each other for quite a long time, defeating the Mega Powers last week for the Team Battle Championships in their first match, getting an opportunity to start the show. But so far, it looks like everybody is taking quite a bit of damage. Game & Watch is the first one down, taken out by a side smash from Bowser. Nice pile driver by Rob on Bowser. Not quite enough to get the kill, though. Bowser's taking a lot of damage. Then again, so has Rob. And there goes Rob! Dark Pit and Bowser with the advantage! Bowser now down one stock, and Dark Pit probably about to join him.
They just need to make up the difference on Team Retro.
There goes Dark Pit. Team Retro is still down in percentages, but what matters are the stocks at the end of the day. You could be at max damage. If you have more stock than your opponent when the match ends, you win. There goes Game & Watch. Not quite enough to get the kill. Nice up smash.
Once again, Rob up over the 100 mark.
Much sooner than Game & Watch this time. There's the up smash, and there goes Rob.
Down to his last stock.
And there goes Game & Watch, a side smash by Dark Pit.
This does not look good for Team Retro.
The Team Battle Champions are on the run, making the current Brawlers and Smashdown Champions very angry earlier tonight. Don't forget their other enemies. The Mega Powers also won their match earlier tonight as a statement to Game & Watch and Rob. Ooh, a level 8 hammer freezes Bowser, but not quite enough to do a whole lot with it. There goes Dark Pit down to his last sock. Bowser almost down there as well. Rob has taken so much damage. He quickly needs to get rid of Bowser. They quickly need to take control of this match.
Whoa.
The up smash and the down aerial by Rob and Mr. Game & Watch combined to take out Bowser. The drop kick! One of the most deadliest moves in Smash, destroying Game & Watch at 70%.
Dark Pit and Bowser with the obvious advantage.
Now a 2-on-1 situation on Rob at 152%. The Flying Slam is going to end it. Also combined with the Electroshock Arm. Team Retro had the advantage over their enemies at the beginning of the show, but at the end of the night, Bowser, the Mega Powers, and Dark Pit had taken control and made a statement against Team Retro. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. Next week, we already have one match set up. Lucina versus Ike, a 300 HP battle. It'll also be interesting to see what Team Retro have to say and do in return to what Dark Pit, Bowser, and the Mega Powers have done tonight.